Cross Interior. Followed by the Bulldog. And then the Cayman. Followed by the Chow Chow. And then the Dalmatian. The German Spitz Prime and the German Spitz Spitz. Now the Japanese Pika. The Japanese Pika. The Japanese Spitz. And now the K-Song. From Leon Berger. Renata Hatzberg. And the miniature scouts. Miniature Boom.
The best of breed here is 13260 in your catalog. It's a dog. Use the first ball as full baiting. After full baiting, the bulldog fought its way through the dog pits. After 1835, the bulldog began to evolve into the shorter face, the more squat version we now know, but still retaining a powerful, undershot jaw. It was in 1860 that the bulldog first came into our show rings. Israel, judged as a second breed today by Mrs. Joyce Mann, with an entry of 13.13, and she chose this one 13402, which is a dog. This is a medium-sized dog of the Spitz type, and of course, should be a well-proportioned dog. Has a history which goes back, way back, for it's reputed that Queen Jezebel had one of these tied to her throne with a golden chain. Chow Chow. This is number 13418. Judged by Mr. Rodney Olin, who had an entry of 131. Comes from China, where it was recognized as a draft dog, a guard dog, and a flock dog. Bluish-black in this breed, with the roof of the mouth and the bluish-black or bluey-black. And also, it's preferable for it to have black gums. Unusual feature, not found in too many breeds. Some believe that the Chow owes its heavy head to a cross with the Tibetan Mastiff. Now we come to the Dalmatian. This one is a dog 13712, selected by our two judges, a note by our judge, Mr. Peter Rands. Sorry, it was the second highest breed entry in the utility group, with 209 for Mr. Rands to go over. Breed of incredible endurance, able to travel forever it can seem at a moderate pace. We all know it, we can see it. It's a distinctively spotted dog. A carrier dog. And the carriers also remember the London fire engines at one time when they were horse drawn. It's a dog which is full of legend. Table now we have the French Bulldog. Mr. Brent Cadogan is the judge with an entry of 86. And the best of breed was the bitch 13757. Some say that lace makers may have had something to do with this breed being attributed to France. During the 1860s, bulldogs reached the height of popularity and toy varieties appeared on the scene, especially in the Midlands where lace making flourished. And it is suggested that small bulldogs may have come to France and some of the lace makers moved there. From these would involve the French bulldog. two varieties of the German Spitz. The first one is the Klein, meaning small. This one's number is 13877, and it's a dog, judged by Mrs. C. Sermon, who had an entry of 68. There are several sizes of German Spitz, graded down from the Wolf Spitz, which is wolf grey only and similar to our Caisson, down to the smallest, the toy variety, which we saw earlier called the Pomerania. We have here in the utility group two of these sizes, the Mickle and the Klein. Here we have the middle, and it was Mrs. Chris Sermon again who judged this breed with an entry of 65, and again she chose a dog, this time the number was 13947. In both, all color varieties and markings are acceptable. Either of the two, the Klein or the Mickle, should give the appearance of a compact, short coupled dog. German Spitz are dogs very adaptable to their conditions. They actually have a very strict family code of conduct, with, for example, the youngest adult being delegated to play with puppies. The Japanese Akita that you now see in the ring is the dog number 14050, selected by Mrs. Meg Purnell Carpenter, who had a very good entry of 173 to go over. And these dogs can weigh anything from 70 to over 110 pounds. And they do actually follow the pattern of most of the native dogs in Japan in that they're square in body, wedge-shaped in head, with smallish upright ears, thick standoff coats, with a tail that curls over the back. Tail should be large and full. The people who originally developed the fighting dogs, but when that sport was favored, they were redirected into hunting deer, wild boar, and black bear. A bold sort of dog, the Akita. Here we have the Japanese Shiba Inu, which literally means the small dog. And the Shiba Inu should look like a smaller version of the Akita. This one is a bitch number 14167. The breed was judged by Mrs. Betty Neath with an entry of 69. Shiba, with its short, harsh, standoff double coat, is an ideal dog for outdoors, said to be able to withstand and enjoy cold weather. This is one of the most popular dogs in Japan, Japanese Shiba Inu. Now we have another one which has Japanese in its name, the Japanese Spitz, a lap-sized Spitz. Spitz-type dog, which descends from long-haired Nordic dogs which were taken to Japan early this century. This was yet another breed today from Mrs. Joyce Mann. She had an entry of 78, and she chose the dog 14258. This is a dog which favours the Samoyed type. Lovely white dog with a smiling face. Known to be bred smaller and smaller in size after it arrived in Japan. The dog stands between 12 and 14 inches. The bitches are slightly smaller. In front of the table, we have the Caisson, judged by Mrs. Pam Luckhurst. And from an entry of 116, she chose this dog 14294. This is a breed of dog which is recalled and remembered on the city seal of Amsterdam. It's a dog with a short, compact body. It should carry itself confidently. It has a fox-like head, small pointed ears, large ruff, and a well-feathered tail which curls over its back. Interesting that the Fédération Cynologique Internationale, the FCI, the International Dog Organization, which registers most breeds, does not register the Caisson. Considers it to be the same breed as the German Wolfspitz, which we mentioned just now. Now we have one of the largest of the dogs in the utility group, the Leon Berger. Judged today by Miss Jean Lanning. She had an entry of 115. Her best of breed was actually a dog. It's number 14422. She'll be a strong, muscular sort of dog. It was created 50 years ago by the mayor of Leonberg to honor his town. An interesting feature about this one is that it is a web-footed dog. The Essex was helped and encouraged by monks from the Hospice of St. Bernard who sent him some dogs for his breeding experiments. Of course, that is the home of the St. Bernard. Table we have the last Apso, which had the top entry in the utility breed, 228. And the judge was Mr. Stuart Chamberlain, who chose as his best breed the dog 14570. One of several Eastern breeds to have made an impact on the Western world. First arrived here in the early 1920s, and then was shown at a show in London. These dogs come in gold, sandy, honey, dark, grizzled, slate. smoke, party colour, black, white or brown, wide variety of colours, and the laws are absent. All are equally acceptable. But when you talk about any one of the three, the giant, the schnauzer, or the miniature, you're talking basically about the same dog, except for the question of size. And in the miniature, the ideal height is 14 inches in the dog and 13 in the bitch. Standard, judged today by Mr. Dennis Coxall. He had a good entry here of 176 and chose this dog 15079. One time the poodle was well established as a water retriever. And the French know this dog, which is believed to have come from the marshlands in Germany, as a dog which could retrieve duck. Believe the standard is actually the oldest of the three varieties. Over the years, the smaller ones hold up in terms of numbers. So after two black poodles, we turn to the toy poodle, which is a white one. And it's also a dog, 15212. There was an entry of 115 for the judge, Mrs. Jackie Ransom. All three of the varieties come in all solid colours, white, green, pink, cot, brown, black, silver and blue. Researching the various breeds of dogs actually throws up some quite interesting facts from time to time. And one concerning the poodles is that the early show dogs were shown with a corded coat, not the coat that we're used to seeing in our legs today. This is the toy 17th and 18th century. The skipper came. A dog, 15300, judged by Mr. Ian Miller, with an entry of 62. Small, cobby, active dog, feeling sharp and foxy expression. The breed comes to us from Belgium, where it's used as a barge dog, but it's also known in Holland. Actually, they originate in that province on the continent, which is known as Flanders. There was a barge owner called Royssens who actually promoted the breed back in the 19th century. Now we come back to the Schnauzer, which is the middle size of the three varieties. This is a dog, 15413. The judge was Mrs. Frances Crahl. There was an entry of 72. The one we're looking at now is required by the standard to be 19 inches at the withers of the dog, 18 in the bitch. And this version, when it was used in Germany, filled many roles. It was a ratter, it was a drover's dog, tended the stock, and it was used as a guard in the house and around the stables. Pretty much an all-round farm dog, as many of our breeds have been over the years. Just in front of the table, we have the Sarpe. This is a bitch, 15518, judged by Mrs. Heather Sweeting. She had an entry of 197. There are many breeds which we can describe as being among the most distinctive in our showrooms today, and the Sarpe certainly is one of them. Comes from China, like the Chacho. Has a black tongue and black mouth pigmentation. The ears particularly are very small and rather thick. Original uses for this breed were a hunting dog, a herding dog, and or a guard dog, used to entertain the locals when they put it in the fighting pits. Now on the table we have the Shih Tzu, the third highest entry in the utility group today, with 192 for Judge Mrs. Susan Crosby. And she chose a dog, 15694. The breed with its roots in Tibet, though its actual development was perfected in China. Dogs like these lived in the luxury of the Chinese imperial palaces, where the Pekingese, of course, also held sway. And there is a belief that Pekingese blood may have been introduced over the years. The Kennel Club calls for the gauge or movement of this particular breed to be arrogant, smooth flowing. This front leg should reach well forward, and the rear action should be showing a full pad as it kicks up its heels. So we're coming towards the end of the utility group. The penultimate dog is now on the table, and that is the Tibetan Spaniel. It's a dog, and its number is 15799, judged by Miss Veronica Burihen, with an entry of 171. Another of the early Tibetan breeds to reach England, probably one of the first actually, came here in about 1900. Early breeders worked hard to eliminate the shorter nose specimens that the present clear distinction from the Pekingese has now achieved. All colours, a mixture of colours, are permitted in the breed. The Tibetan Spaniel. And the last of our utility dogs is the Tibetan Terrier. This is a dog, actually, 15929, chosen by Mrs. Vita Davies, who had a very good entry of 185. It isn't actually a terrier, in spite of its name, but it is a herding dog. And the male can stand up to 16 inches at the shoulder, with the female slightly less. The breed developed from old and long-established types of dog, one of which was not too dissimilar to a poodle. The Tibetan Terrier really worked for his living as a double cigar and a herding dog. And was used very often to guard the caravans of traders. So, now our judge is going to have another quick look along the line before she shortlists, and as I said, we can expect something like 6 to 8 dogs. Of course, the dogs which win their groups here tonight go forward for tomorrow, when we have this show. Already qualified for Sunday night. We have a Bouvier, a Welsh Terrier, and an Afghan. And of course, in the toy group tonight, we had the Maltese. There were 2,913 dogs which were entered in total for this utility group. And now we're going to see which one of all those dogs is going to become the group winner. First out is the Chow Chow, followed by the French Bulldog, the Japanese Akita, the Shih Tzu, Standard poodle. Oh, it is the last one, I'm so sorry. Standard poodle, and I think we're having one more. Yes, we're having a schnauzer. Charles X Bulldog with Peter. Laza, standard poodle, and the schnauzer. This is Monica and Roger Black is now saying thank you to all the others and the dealers, shaking hands with them, congratulating them on getting this far in the competition. Japanese Akita, 1-4-5. Standard poodle 15079. And now it's the schnauzer 15413. Sadly, the woman doesn't keep the bars, but takes away. place to the Japanese Akita, third place to the Standard Poodle. And the rosette too for the Los Angeles. Congratulations to all of them. And ladies and gentlemen, a very big hand please to our judge, Monica Bodger-Black, for John Belmont. And ladies and gentlemen, brings us to the end of showing here on the third day of Crux 1998. And as the dogs lead us,